What's up, guys? Welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman. In today's video, we are going to import 3D objects into AGK2. Yes, you can make 3D games in AGK2. First, we're going to need a 3D object, okay? So let's make one. If you don't have Maya, download the student version. It's free. So we're gonna make something super simple. So let's go to polygons and let's make a box. Just like yesterday. Was it yesterday? I can't remember. And if you press 5, you can shade it. Let's apply a material to this. I'm gonna go to rendering. And let's float this with, say, green. Let me save this. So I'm under rendering. Okay, so let's go to texturing. And let's open the 3D painting tool. Oops, I forgot to open the window. So let's assign a texture to the object. This is going to be 1024 by 1024. Also, make sure this is a JPEG. Let's assign the texture. And we're going to do the same thing we did yesterday. Let's make it bigger. There is the other eye. Let me give him some spots. Give him spots everywhere. And we're going to export this as an object. Okay, so let me go File. Select All. And make sure you're exporting this as an object. Now, if you can't see this, all you have to do is go to Window, Settings, Plugin Manager, and make sure that you are loading Export Object. I got mine set to Auto Load, and I'm going to call mine Libbox. Okay, so let's close Maya. Let's open AGK2. I got this code from the example files. And we're actually moving in 3D here, but we don't have any objects to look at. So let's load our green happy face. Let me zoom in. This is before the do, by the way. Before the main loop. So let's call this a super box. And it's going to be equals load object. And, our object is called libbox.obj. We need a texture for this, so let's call this a superbox texture. Just text, I guess. Equals load image. Now for the image, let me get the name of the image. 3D paint textures. Let me get the texture. Under media, let me paste this here. It looks like I saved my object in the wrong folder, so let me go get it. Let's paste it. And there is our OBJ. Let me just take the name of this texture, copy it, and this is what we're going to use for the name of the texture. Paste it. So now we need to apply the texture to the object. So it's going to be set object image, and it's going to be super box, super box texture. Zero. Let's try it out. Whoa! It kind of works. Okay, we're not loading the texture correctly. Let's see what's happening. The extension. We forgot the extension. It's going to be .jpg. Let's run it. Wow, it's so small. Holy macro. We can either make this bigger in Maya or we can simply scale it in AGK. So let's set the object scale. Object scale. The object is a super box 000 for X, Y, and Z. And we want to scale this maybe 1, 1, 1. Let's try it out. That's still very small. Let's try 4. Let's go 5, 5, 5. Try it out. And that's not too bad there. I'm happy with that size. Let's load another box. Copy this. And paste it. Let's call this a box 1. Texture 1. Everything 1. And maybe we can position the boxes in different places. Set object position. And the object is a super box. And we're gonna go 000 for X, Y, and Z. We can leave that one like that. Let's copy this, paste it, and this will be box 1 Maybe we can move this 100 pixels on the X. Let's run this. And there is our second box. Let me do one more. Let's copy the whole thing. And this will be box 2. Everything 2. Another 200 pixels away from the first one. And there we go. We have 3 boxes. Wow. Now, right now, I don't have any collisions assigned to this. But I will post another video for that after. Now, if you notice, this has virtual buttons. Wow, they're a lot of fun. And the reason for that is because this can be exported to mobile devices. You can see that this is extremely simple. There is nothing to it. Okay, so you can download this example from the description below. Down below, you can see a subscribe button. Subscribe. Make sure to smack the like button and maybe share the video. Thanks for watching. And I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.